Annyeonghaseyo. Chonun kyosaimnida. So, se irumun Christine-nida. So, nabusog naman kayo sa lunch natin. Kasi parang na-burn out ko na yung calorie kanina. Yung tayo ng basketball. So, na-tense ako doon. So, anyway. Appropriate naman since after lunch, it's about food. Yun, share ko lang bago ko i-present yung aking study. Nung nilaman ko na natanggap yung proposal ko, so excited ako, sinabi ko sa mommy ko, uy, may natanggap yung paper ko dun, ay yung proposal ko dun sa, ano, tungkol sa Samgyupsal. Sabi niya, anak, nag-invento ka na naman ah, gusto mo lang kumain, nagdadahilan ko. So, can you promise it to yung acceptance? Ano, so, ano yun eh, hirap kasi mag-research, diba? So, ako kasi pag na-i-stress ako, ang stress buster ko, kumain. So, para double purpose, nakakakain ako at the same time, at nakakapag-research. So, isip ko, why not, diba? Gawin na lang nating double purpose. Nakakakain ako at the same time, nakakapag-research. Para inspiring. So, the title of my research is Samgyupsarap, Analysis of the Filipino Taste on Korean Grilled Meat Treats in the Context of Culture. So, why context of culture? Kasi my current program is MA Araling Filipino. So, I like to study about Samgyupsal in the context of Philippine studies. So, this is the rationale or background of my study. So, if you go to malls and kung anumang food strip na dinadaanan natin in Metro Manila, sureness yon na marati tayo may makakitang restaurant na nagsaserve ng samgyupsal, like samgyup, salamat, and romantic babol. So, primarily, what I like to find out is, anong mga factors which contributed to the rise of Korean restaurants serving grilled meats in Metro Manila? And I also would like to find out the innovativeness and creativeness of these Korean restaurants to attract their customers. If you would see, yung binigay kong example, di ba? Samgyup salamat, right? At saka romantic baboy. So, sa pangalan pa lang, napaka-creative na. Parang nakakaingan yung kumain. So, another purpose of my study is that I like to identify why Korean restaurants offering unlimited grilled meats have become popular among Filipinos. And part of my study as well is to categorize the kind of customers who frequent this kind of restaurants. Now, for the American novelist Jonathan Safran Foer, who wrote Eating Animals, he said that food is not rational. Food is culture, habits, craving, and identity. Thus, this research would like to relate if the popularity of eating samgyupsal is influenced by watching Korean novela or the impact of having Korean friends from school or the workplace. And lastly, the paper would like to connect the interest of Filipino foodies on Korean grilled meat as an aspect of culture since Filipinos are fond of eating roast pork or chicken like pork barbecue or that sort. So why is the study relevant? Okay, so according to Mark Twain, he said that part of the success in life is to be able to eat what you want. So, in learning about the Pinoy foodie, especially in the context of why they eat samgyupsal, it's important as it's a new approach in learning about the values and attitudes of the Filipinos at present, especially the millennials and the Generation Z. For the journalist Michael Pulan, he said that sharing food increases its level as a family and a community ritual associated with ritual. So, yung food, hindi lang siya perceived now as something biological na kailangan kainin, but yung pagpili ng pagkain, the food that you eat, the food, yung pinili mong pagkain is part already of your values, including how you share it with your family and friends. So learning about the Pinoy foodies in terms of what they eat, especially samgyupsal, gives a new perspective in Philippine studies as well as Filipino pop culture to food. So by learning what a Filipino foodie eats, where he dines, especially in Korean restaurants serving samgyupsal, we can learn better about the current lifestyle and preferences of Filipino foods. So what's my theoretical framework for this study? Since background ko nga is counseling and Philippine studies, so I use the framework of Virgilio Enriquez Psikolohiyang Pilipino. So, through Psikolohiyang Pilipino, we could see how the Filipino values his kapwa. So, in the context of food, hindi lang yung pagkain itself, but pag kumakain, based dun sa initial na findings ko, when a Filipino foodie eats, he takes into consideration, he values his kapwa, others, which can be his friends, neighbors, family. So, in choosing where to eat and what to eat, the Pinoy foodie shows how he takes into consideration his family and peers. So, when the Pinoy foodie eats with his classmates or friends, values show like makikitungo, interaction, participation, and most of all, fellowship or pakikisama. Furthermore, through Psikolohiyang Pilipino, it can show that if Pinoy foodie is considerate about sharing food with his family or friends. Diba usually, lahat ba kayo na-try nyo nang kumain sa samgyupsal? Diba mission nga, may hashtag, samgyup is life. Kasi yung mga gano'n, pag usually mga Friday nights or weekends, gusto natin kumain with our friends, right? So, sa pamamagitan ng Psikolohiyang Pilipino, it enables us how a Pinoy foodie eating samgyupsal shows his love, concern, friendship, and cooperation by means of food. So in terms of conceptual framework, I use the concept of transculturation. So in transculturation, it refers to the encounter of two or more cultures through interaction and relation. So I use transculturation since we are Filipinos and more or less we have our own set of values and culture as compared with Korean culture. In terms of methodology, so since dining experience involves sharing stories with family or friends, so I employed a narrative analysis. So why narrative analysis? Because according to Berger, a narrative involves a story that describes a personal experience with a person or place. So, since the study is about Philippine culture, as I have mentioned in the theoretical framework which I have chosen, I employed Enriquez methodology, pagbumasid, meaning participant observation and interview pagtatanong. So, in the interview, since I'm also a teacher, I interviewed some of my Korean students, how they perceive samgyupsal, their Korean grilled as compared with Filipino barbecue. I also interviewed the people who dined in the restaurants that I went. In terms of target participants, I used random sampling. But I chose convenient sampling in terms of the location of restaurants. So convenient sampling because since I work and I also study, so I only chose Korean restaurants along Katipunan near UP Diliman and where I reside at Lilac since there are already a number of Korean restaurants that offer samgyupsal. For random sampling, I want to get more or less a general feel of the population. And just I'd like to share pala. So, I chose random sampling. I had a previous study about food park, and this is my observation. Sa buffet, kapag nag-random sampling, maiinit ulo ng mga tao, hindi sila ganun ka-approachable. Kasi nga isip ko, sobrang naman ito kumakain. But surprisingly, when I did the random sampling, like yung Korean restaurant, diba? Hindi siya buffet, tapos buffet, may konting inuman, friendly yung mga tao, mas accommodating sila na mag-entertain ng questions. Tapos invite ka pa nila, gusto mo kumain? Ganun. And then the study was started late December 2018. sa family reunion kasi nagbutuhan kami. Oh, sige, gusto kumain. So, may sabi, ano tayo? Vikings. Eh, Vikings din ang mga kasawa. So, invitation outnumbered yung mga Thunders. So, yung nanalo sa Samgyupsal. Yan. Tapos, na-fascinate ako dun sa initial na observation ko. So, since 2018 ng late December, hanggang yun, ongoing yung study ko. At saka reason para kumain pa rin. Para-paraan yun. So, for my review of related literature, so according to the essay Where's the Batiste of Carmen Guerrero Nakfield, she cited that a Filipino may denationalize himself but not his stomach. Hence, we could say that food reflects Filipino identity. Filipinos are inherently generous when they share their meal. Now, according to Ms. Willie Santa Maria in her Tasting History published by Business World, she said that food brings happiness and satisfaction among Filipinos. So, based on my initial study, I have observed that whenever Filipinos eat samgyupsal, it's not just about eating good food, but it's more on sharing the food with someone you're comfortable with, like your family, your friends. According to Binocritis, pop culture is a manifestation of globalization at present. So, eating samgyupsal can be categorized as a pop culture. So, the Pinoy foodie creates a new trend or lifestyle for the middle class and the younger generation. So, di ba minsan, kapag dinin yung social media, di ba gumagamit ng hashtag? So, may mga hashtag nila, samgyupsal is life, or samgyupsal, or yung mga mukbang. Yeah. So, based on my initial findings, malaking impact ng K-dramas sa influence ng pagkahilig ng mga Filipinos ng samgyupsal. Why? Because in most Korean dramas, we could see na may mga scene, di ba, na kumakain sila as a family or with their friends. And kasama dun sa kinakain nila, yung samgyupsal. And dito sa Philippines, or yeah, lalo na sa pag pinilabas sa TV yung Korean dramas, madalas kailan ini-air, di ba, lunchtime or dinner, no? Lakas maka-attract ng audience yun, lalo na pag kunwari pinapakita na samgyupsal yung kinakain. Another findings, sa Metro, sa Malate especially, maraming nag-offer ng samgyupsal doon. So, among the young foodies, Korean grilled or samgyupsal is one of the most popular or actually pinaka-popular. Why? Because unlike pork barbecue sold on the streets with some parts burned as it was roasted on charcoal, sa Korean restaurant, pag kumain ka ng samgyupsal, una, hindi ganun kauso. Okay? So, hindi masyadong, siguro kung medyo middle class yung kakain, hindi siya mausok, hindi didikit yung amoy dun sa buhok mo. Although yung samgyupsal, it doesn't have the sweet sauce like we have in our pork barbecue. Pinoy foodie, especially the younger generation, the millennials and the Gen Z, they patronize it because of the experience of grilling one's food together with friends. Sino sa inyo yung naka-experience mag-samgyupsal? Raise your hands, please. Sige, put your hands down. Nasa nyo rin ba yung feeling na nakakatuwang kayo mag-iihaw ng sarili nyong food? Kasi diba, iba yung, syempre nakakatuwa na si kuya na nag-barbecue. Medyo fascinating na nakita yun. Ay, ano na siya, naluluto na siya, nasusunod na siya. Pero iba yung feeling na, yun yung, nung tinanong ko yung ibang, yung mga respondents ko, lalo na yung mga generations Z, siguro hindi pa nila experience magluto sa bahay or wala na kasing home ec sa high school. Tumutuwa sila doon sa feeling na sila nagluluto ng pagkain nila, yung nakikita nilang, appreciate nila yung nakikita nila, uy, naluto yung pagkain, edible pala yung niluto nila na hindi nasunog. What else? Bakit naging click yung Samgyupsal? Okay. So ano ba yung taste ng Pinoy foodie, especially yung younger generation? So artistic ambiance. According to Marinetti, in his book, The Futurist Cookbook, he said that yung food, it's a form of art. So based dun sa findings ko, observation and interview, yung mga millennials at saka Gen Z na kumakain ng Samgyupsal, bet nilang kumain doon. Bakit? Kasi apart from yung taste, may certain presentation, di ba? Unlike kasi kung munta kayo sa street or kay Mang Larry, nakaano lang yan, nakahilera lang, tumbok-tumbok lang yung skewer ng barbecue. Pero sa Samgyupsal, may certain part siya, di ba? Iba-iba yung pag-iba-iba yung flavor, tapos ang dami pang side dish. So it's an art. Tapos magpapapicture kayo din yun. So picture-picture muna, post yun sa Instagram. Okay, so the Hinoy foodie likes a vibrant look. Okay, so nakaka-vibrant look yung Samgyupsal, especially kapag may mga kasama siyang side dish. At apart from that, you're able to share it in social media. Siyempre, parang sabi, eh, ba't hindi pa ganun din pag kumain kayo ng barbecue ko lang kay Mang Larry? Sabi, hindi po ate, kasi sa sidewalk lang yun, you know, mausok. And like, pag kumain kayo sa Samgyupsal, medyo magandang ambience. Tapos, yung feeling yung may grill. So, pwede nyo siyang i-share sa Instagram. So, in short, yung Samgyupsal for the respondents that I have interviewed, which are millennials and Gen Z, hindi na kasi masarap yun, no? Sa kanila, it's a level up version. So may twist dun sa flavor and presentation. What else? So based on my observation, apart from millennials and Gen Z who eat with their classmates or with their friends, nandun din kasi yung concept that you share Samgyupsal with your family, with your friends during occasion, yung nagpapakita ng kinship, ng bonding. What else? Easy on the pockets. Bakit patok yung Korean Samgyupsal? Syempre yung buffet, medyo mahal siya, right? So mga magkano ba yung rate niya? Mga nasa, kung sa Viking siya, mga around nasa 800 plus. But as compared with Korean Samgyupsal, nasa around 499 yung standard. So based on my initial findings, yung Pinoy foodie, nandun yung concept nila ng kailangan yung gagastos nila on food, spent wisely. So, kaya patok yung Samgyupsal. And of course, nandun yung concept of creativeness and innovativeness. If you've served yung, di ba, yung Samgyup, salamat, and yung romantic baboy. So, you could see that on an entrepreneur side, nandun yung creative manner of delivering or creating a restaurant offering grilled meat. Yeah, so those are my initial findings. So thank you very much.